Hello guys, in this video actually we are going to learn what is integration and what is the physical meaning of integration. Now, before going into the physical meaning, let us see, I'll slowly come to what is the integration, but how the integration, how, what was the use of it and how did it came into picture. Okay, why did the mathematician derive the term called integration, or they formulated it? So, to know it, now let us take an example. Suppose we know area of a rectangle . Suppose this is a rectangle, okay, this is L length and this is width. We know area of rectangle is length into width. Correct. This is the assumption that we'll do. This is what we'll assume that this is correct. This is actually correct. Okay. Now, to start with, I'll take two problems. One which is simple, and second one is the more detailed application of integration. Okay. Now, suppose assuming that this is correct, I want to know what is the area of this triangle. It's a triangle, okay, this is, let us say, 4 meters. I'll take a real problem, then this also is 4 meters. Okay, so I have axis, this is x-axis, this is y-axis. Now, in integration, what we'll do is, basically, anywhere, wherever you apply integration, we'll try to find out something which is unknown from things that we already know. Now, this is for the same reason actually I told you that this is what we know. Area of rectangle is length into width. Now, okay, basically we know what is the area of this triangle. Triangle is equal to half into base into height. Okay, which we can derive is area of rectangle actually. This area of triangle, it's this rectangle actually. Suppose if you make this rectangle, okay, so rectangle is equal to area of rectangle is twice into area of triangle. Area of this triangle and this triangle is all is similar. It's, okay, we know from geometry. So this is length, base into height, let us say is equal to 2 into area of triangle. From this we get area equal to half into base into height. This is what we know exactly, but this I'll prove it. This is one way of proving it, but this I'll prove it from integration. Now, to get this area of triangle from integration, what I'll do is I have this triangle. Okay, now what I'll do is, I'll find out area from whatever I know. This is, I know area of rectangle, which is length. So I'll break this triangle into 3 parts. Okay, I'll break this thing in 3 parts. All is fine. Okay, I'll break this thing into 3 parts. What I'll do is, I'll make a rectangle. Okay, this is rectangle 1. This is rectangle 2, this is rectangle 3. Now, you may question is, why I am not choosing this rectangle? Okay. I may as well choose this rectangle. Correct? Now, what I will get is, if I choose and if I add all the area of this rectangle 1, R1, R2, R3. If I add area of all this rectangle, it is equal to summation of area of that small rectangle. Okay, this area we already know it is additive. Right. Now, if I add area of all these 3 rectangles, I will get approximate area of triangle with this error. This will be error. This area. this extra area I'll get, or in this case I'll get less area, and the amount of area, less area that I'll get will be equal to area of this guy. Now this is a pretty big error. Now, suppose if I want to make this error small, what I'll do is I'll slice this rectangle into smaller pieces. Okay, and I'll do this. So this is the area of this area that I get. Okay, so I have minimized this error either on plus side or minus side, or on minus side. If I do it on minus side, what I'll get is this much. Okay, so this is actually an error, this R error, and in this case this is error. In this case error is positive, in this case error is negative, but I am getting close to it. How do I know why I am getting close to it? Now assume that this is a paint, this is like a pen with the pretty much, which has a wide nib, or what I can say, wide, pretty wide pointer. Or you can assume that this is a paintbrush. I painted this thing with a paintbrush with a vertical stroke, or I painted this with a vertical stroke. The area that is left is an error. The amount of paint that is there in that paint that is used is equal to an area, but where the paint I could not paint it, that is a error. Now to understand this, if I take to prove that, if I take a paint brush of a sufficiently small size, in this case I reduce the paint brush area, the width of a paint brush to smaller thing. Now to get the exact area, what I'll do is I'll take a paint brush which is equal to, the width of the paintbrush is equal to the width of a hair. So I'll do all this painting like this. Okay, so if I do all this painting like this, everybody can say that the area that I will be leaving, this error, will be minimized. Okay, so by this logic actually we can say the area, if I take a very small paintbrush with a very small width, the area that it will cover will be almost 99.9999 perfect. If I go for even smaller area, I'll complete almost 100% area. So the error will be reduced. So one thing is, smaller the width or larger the partitions, number of partitions, error will be reduced, or smaller the error. Now to get error equal to 0, will become 0 when partition, or this, what I will define this thing as dx, and what I'll do dx, and dx for error, if I want error to become 0, I have to make dx tends to 0. Okay, this is a proof, a logical proof. Okay, this is we have understood, and this is we have understood. Now to get area, what I'll do is I'll take this arbitrary rectangle. Okay, its height will be y, this is y, so its height will be y, and this width will be dx. Now as you already know, area of triangle is equal to sum of area of all rectangle and square as rectangle, which is y, area of this small arbitrary rectangle, this rectangle is y into dx. Okay, and if I move this thing from point A, which is 0 to 4, okay, I'll get area. If I add all area of small rectangles from 0 to 4, I'll get area of this triangle. Correct, na? So, equation of y. This equation of this line, I have taken this purposefully. we can get from mathematics that equation of line is y equal to x. This is 4, this is 4. What the x value is 2, then y also will be 2. If x is 4, y also will be 4. Okay. So this actually is summation. This summation of all the rectangles from 0 to 4. This summation, if I make this dx or delta x smaller when dx tends to 0, this summation okay of area of rectangle when x equal to 0 to 4, I have to move this rectangle from this point to this point in x direction. So from x equal to 0, if I sum all these rectangles y dx, if I limit x tends to 0 or dx tends to 0, this becomes integration of y dx, and the limit of integration will be the starting point and ending point 0 to 4. Now if I put this equation y equal to x, what I will get is 0 to 4 x dx. Now from integration, actually basically we know this integration of x is equal to x squared by 2 with this limit 0 to 4. So we will get 4 squared by 2 minus 0 squared by 2. That is 8 meters square. And half into base into height is half into base is 4 into 4. It also comes as 8. This is what we have proved. From integration, area of triangle was 8. And from the basic mathematics, or from common sense, area of this triangle also was 8. Half into base into height. This is the integration. Thanks. If you want to know, this is a simple, this the answer we were knowing, and this was pretty simple. Now to know the detailed application as other application of integration, please watch my next video. And if you like my video, please share, subscribe or comment. Okay, either positive or negative. If you don't like that, also you can say what you didn't like. That will be a good feedback for me. Okay, thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day.